Thank you. Good morning and welcome to St. Ambrose. Our opening song this morning is How Great Thou Art, number 432, 432. We will sing verses 1, 3, and 4.
Before we begin singing, I will invite you to stand and face the back. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Kathy died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. During her baptism, Kathy was clothed with Christ. May she now be clothed in glory. So we shall now join in singing the hymn.
I hear the roaring thunder.
who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity. We humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Kathy to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We shall now have our first reading.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if in the sight of men they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in the Lord shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your mercy be on
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you, in accordance with the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. That you, rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the holy ones what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to accomplish far more than all we ask or imagine, by the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Jesus Christ, to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste, to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Most blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his handmaid's lowliness. Behold, from now on, all ages will call me blessed. The Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age to those who fear him. He has shown the might with his arm, dispersed the arrogant of mind and heart. He has thrown down rulers from their thrones, but lifted up the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things. The rich he has sent away empty. He has helped Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, according to the promise of our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her for about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
We all had things to do today. And Kathy's death kind of interrupted the whole thing. But here we are because we love her and we love one another. Now, it is widely believed that the originator of what has become a widely used meme was the Lone Ranger, who sometimes closed his weekly Western with the words, "My work is done here." Recently, I read in an obscure journal of incredible credibility that the first person to utter these words was not the Lone Ranger, but the young Virgin Mary. These are similar words came to her mind and possibly to her lips as she packed her things to go back home after helping her elderly cousin Elizabeth bring to birth a very special baby. John would be the Baptist. I made that up. And I think that Kathy would have laughed because she was kind. And just maybe, as Kathy passed from our time and space into eternity, it might have occurred to her, "Looks like my work is done here." Not that she made her life look like work. All the service she gave here at St. Ambrose and around the library, all the loving that she gave, poured out on her nieces and nephews and their kids too. Oh, and the care she gave her parents in their old age looked like loving devotion more than a chore. She made it look easy, all the care she gave us. She used her gifts generously. She made it easy for us to love her. Kathy, as the oldest of five siblings, assumed the role of guide and protector. What she learned from her loving parents, she practiced in a lifelong pattern of attention to the individuals around her. Carefully chosen gifts and cards on all the personal and family occasions. Did she have stock in Hallmark? And many of her gifts were not purchased, though they did cost her something. The cost of paying loving attention to the people in your circle of family and friends and needy folks of whatever stripe can be a high cost, because it means turning your attention toward them and away from yourself. This is the way of Jesus and of Mary, his mother. The gospel we heard a few minutes ago is the story of a gift of care from a young woman with a story to tell. "Have I got news for you?" And a gift of kind service to an older woman in her extended family with a story of her own. After Mary heard of Elizabeth's late in life pregnancy, she hurried to see how she could help. Their babies, Elizabeth's and Mary's, were, the two mothers knew, a gift from God. And Mary's baby, Jesus, was coming into the world to carry out the plan of God to renew humanity and the whole world with the spirit of love, generous love. The old path that we naturally follow, I'm first, you come after me, is not what the human race is built for. We are made for loving each other and forming a family where our love for one another cushions the harshness of life and prepares us for the unavoidable shocks that come with losses, like the loss we all feel today in varying degrees. In Jesus' life, we do not see him arranging things for his own selfish benefit, ever. He came to be, to live, and to die for us. He went about doing good and healing us of our self-centeredness by calling us to a new way, love of others, that we can do as we begin to believe what Jesus represents. And in giving his life so generously for us, Jesus placed himself in the Father's care and showed us the hope of life beyond the door of death. Kathy was schooled in the way of Jesus. She was not afraid of the work involved in serving us, nor of the necessary cost to her own comfort and convenience. She believed in Jesus and in his way of self-sacrificing love. And her life of generosity, kindness, loyalty, thoughtfulness, it was a cheerful life, marked by tenderness wrapped in humor. The prayer of St. Paul that we heard today as our second reading is a family prayer. I'd like to pray it for us now, sort of in Kathy's name. I kneel before the Father from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you, in accord with the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in our hearts through faith, that rooted and grounded in love, we may have strength to comprehend with all the holy ones how broad and long and high and deep is the love of God for us, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that we may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to accomplish far more than all we could ask or imagine by the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto Kathy, O Lord,
and let her perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May she live forever in peace.
Amen.
Now I'm going to invite all of you to stand as we offer our prayers and our petitions on behalf of Kathy.
For Kathy Hageman, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may be welcome into the company of saints, let us pray to the Lord.
The Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister Kathy, who ate of the bread of life, the body of Christ, that she may be raised up on the last day according to Jesus' promise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Kathy's family and friends, that they may be consoled in their grief by our Lord Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, that let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the world and unity in the church, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now invite the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Our song during the preparation of the gifts is Hail Mary, Gentlewoman, number 707.
Thank you.
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Kathy, we beseech your mercy that she, who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying, as one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Kathy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our beloved brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await a blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen. And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace, 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 peace. Peace.
Go to communion first as usual.
Done with it?
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter into your house, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. So for communion, we are going to use the center aisle on both sides. So we just come that way.
Our communion song is Be Not Afraid, number 439.
Wander far in safety, though you do not know the way.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Kathy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for a minute. So before we do the concluding rites, Terry, is there anybody who would like to say any remembrance? Okay, I think Tim would like to remember Kathy in some special way.
I don't know if I can do Kathy any justice speaking about her today, because she was above and beyond what I knew as a sister. Just by everyone here and all the people that we've met, I've learned that she's been very generous, very outgoing, very loving, and I could use all the superlatives in the world, but I wouldn't be able to finish. I would just like to thank everyone for coming. She was the glue that held our family together. And I just hope and pray that we can continue to be as close and loving as we were with Kathy. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim. Is there anyone else who would like to say something before I close? Yes. So I know for the entire time I've been here at St. Ambrose, I've worked with her almost every day. So I came the first day of March 2020. Then just a week later, everything was shut down. So I remember during Easter that year, everything was shut down, and we broadcasted the mass just right here. Myself, Father Jim, Kathy, and Kathy Sheffield. So only the four of us. We tried to broadcast the mass to all of you who are at home at that time. So, and we have worked very closely, and she has been a very reliable person. Very kind, very generous, and she has offered a lot, made her a great contribution to the parish. So on behalf of the parish, I want to thank her. So that gratitude goes to the family on her behalf. So thank you for sharing her with St. Ambrose. We are truly blessed. I know she was very close to Father Jim, my predecessor. And as you know him, right? You know the kind of Irishman he was. So I was just thinking, Father Jim went to be with the Lord last year. So I'm thinking, now Kathy is showing up in heaven. And Father Jim is there looking and saying, what the hell are you doing here? And he's going to say, welcome to eternity. Yes, enjoy life. So I want to thank you all for participating in this Mass to give a wonderful send-off to our dear sister. Thank you to Monsignor and the Deacon and Eric up here. Monsignor, you have something to say before we close?
I already had my say.
Okay. Good. Okay, so I'm going to offer the commendation before we sing the song of farewell. Let us arise. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Kathy, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Kathy again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. So we'll now have the song of farewell.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal.
Father of mercies, we commend our sister Kathy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Kathy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Kathy, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now in peace. Let us take our sister to her resting place. Thanks
be to God.
And we have a luncheon after this. All are invited at the, across the parking lot to the other, in the other building.
Our closing song is Amazing Grace, number 439.
450.
Actually, 450.
Just checking.